Hello everyone, hope you are all doing great. It is your friendly neighborhood aircraft maintenance engineer Aziz. And today I'm gonna be explaining my favorite aircraft, Concorde, which is also one of the best aircraft of all time. Let's go. Concorde is my favorite aircraft, but let's see what other people thought about it. For example, the Lord of Save Concorde Group said that it was probably more advanced than Apollo 11, which put first man on the moon. Also, a pilot who flew with Concorde so many times said that no military plane can came anywhere close it. It was so maneuverable and so powerful that even ex-fighter pilots weren't used to it. It was so powerful. Can you imagine it? Also, you should know that when the time Toronto International Air Show came, 750,000 people came to watch Concorde. Can you imagine it? People called Concorde with so many names, but you should also know that they called Wizard. Can you imagine an aircraft named Wizard? But first of all, why did name it Concorde? Let's see. Two companies, one British, one French, merged into one during the expansion and started to work on the planes. And when the time October 1st, 1969 came, this aircraft made its first successful flight. And they named it Concorde, which means harmony, union and agreement. Concorde takeoff speed is 220 knots and landing speed is 170 knots. Concorde can fly at Mach 2.04, which means you can fly between New York and London in less than 3 hours. Concorde flights consisted of 9 crew members, 2 pilots, 1 flight engineer and 6 cabin attendants. Concorde fly with 100 passengers. Last commercial Concorde flight was from New York to Heathrow on October 24th, 2003.
Now, as it's coming into land,
he'll be doing roughly about 157 knots, something like that.
When Concorde retired, it was the last aircraft that fly with flight engineer as a crew member. This amazing supersonic aircraft wasn't only carrying passengers, it was used to carry diamonds and human organs as well. During its lifespan, Concorde had over 50,000 flights and 2.5 million people flew with Concorde. Unfortunately, I am not one of them. It was the first aircraft that flew around the world by British Airlines on November 8, 1986. It was one of the airliners who has Delta configuration wings. Mainly high temperature aluminum alloy construction allowed low weight and conventional manufacture. Full regime autopilot and autothrottle allowed handoff control of the aircraft from climb out to landing. Hydraulic systems used 4.1000 PSI. There was 3 independent hydraulic systems, blue, green and yellow. There was also rudder for emergency situations. Pitch trim was performed by shifting fuel fore and aft after Mach 1 with no drag penalty. One of the things that made me amazed when I learned about Concorde, there was no auxiliary power unit on Concorde. The reason is that Concorde could only visit large airports which has ground air charge.
Surged from the mighty Rolls-Royce engines as the ground crew checked, rechecked and checked again.
Concorde had 4 strong engines which made taxiing so difficult. So the pilots needed to turn off two engines to make taxiing a little easier. Concorde cruising altitude was nearly 60,000 feet. You could see the curvature of the Earth while drinking your champagne. Also, due to intense heat of the airframe, at the end of the air flights, every surface, even the windows, were so warm to touch. You knew how fast and high up you were going at all times, thanks to those tiny drop-down monitors. Each Concorde was more expensive than even the most advanced fighter jets. Converted to today's dollar, each Concorde cost $200 million. That's more than F-22 Raptor, which is the most expensive fighter jet. Concorde was the first airliner to use fly-by-wire. Concorde was so beloved that after its debut, they issued the from its name. So you can never see someone calling it the Concorde. Although so many people loved Concorde, there was also anti-Concorde project. Concorde was prohibited from supersonic flights over some countries, included United States. You know that Concorde was so fast, but could Concorde go faster? Concorde's top speed wasn't limited by its power. It's limited because the temperature. At Mach 2, the friction from moving through the air hits the aluminum skin almost to the point at which it begins to soften. Concorde was painted with very special white paint to adapt temperature changes and to dissipate heat generated from supersonic flights. Although two Concorde was painted blue for promotional reasons, but they were limited to fly at Mach 2. You can also see why most of the airplanes are white. The link is here. The reason that nose cone moves up and down was to help pilots during landing and taxiing. Because of the shape of the wing, the plane needed a high angle of approach and high speed to produce sufficient lift at the relatively low speeds used for landing and takeoff. The long and sleek nose was great at supersonic speeds, but blocked pilots' vision of the runway. The landings were such a steep angle, so they put a special wheel at the tail of the airplane. Without the bumper wheel, there was a high risk the nozzles of the engines could touch the ground first. Believe me, you don't want that. Have you ever heard of carbon brakes? Meet their grandparents. Dunlop specially developed a set of brakes to cope with the immense heat generated by increased landing speed. Slowing a large jet from 170 miles per hour isn't the easiest thing in the world. Concorde was grounded after its one and only major crash on June 25th, 2000. Its first flight after that, September 11th, 2001. Of the originally 20 mates, just two of them are no longer with us. The one that crashed and the other one that disassembled. And what about the rest? You can see most of them at various airports and museums around the world. So, why did they retire such an amazing aircraft? First, the big crash at 2000s. Second, high operation cost. If you want to know more about why they retired Concorde, you can comment below. This story is about to end, but our adventure just begun. If you want to join my adventure, you can subscribe and take your seat in my aircraft. You can also refuel my aircraft by liking the videos and inviting your friends. And this is the end of the story. See you at next adventure.